Om Namah Shivaya.
Today's topic is techniques of managerial control. Techniques of managerial control are of two types, traditional techniques and modern techniques. Traditional techniques include personal observation, which enables the manager to collect first-hand information about the person. It basically creates the psychological pressure on the employees to perform well because they are aware that they are being overserved personally on their job. Then statistical report or statistical analysis in the forms of averages, percentages, ratios, correlation, which help in presenting useful information to manager regarding the performance of the organization in various areas. Right. Then break-even analysis. It is a very important technique used by the manager to study the relationship between cost, volume and profit. It helps a firm in keeping a close check over its variable cost and determines the level of activity at which the firm can earn its target, that is profit. Then budgetary control techniques, in which operations are planned in a form of budgets. For example, sales budget cannot be prepared without knowing production programs and schedules. Now coming to the modern techniques of controlling, these techniques have been recently developed by organizations. These include return on investment, which provides the basic yardstick for measuring whether the capital invested has been used effectively or not. Then ratio analysis technique of controlling, which refers to analysis of financial statements under liquidity ratio, then solvency ratio, profitability ratio and turnover ratio. Then responsibility accounting system, in which different sections, divisions and departments of an organization are set up, responsibility centers like costs center, then revenue center, profit center, investment center, right, for achieving their respective target. Then management audit system of controlling, which improves coordination in the functioning of various departments so that they work together effectively towards achievement of organizational objectives. Then program evaluation and review technique and critical path method. These techniques deals with time scheduling and resource allocation and aims effective execution of projects within given schedule and structure of costs. These techniques are used extensively in areas like shipbuilding, construction projects and aircraft manufacture. Next is management information system, which provides data and information to the managers at the right time so that appropriate corrective action may be taken in case of deviations from standards.